Hello, everybody. My name is S.Wang. I'm a program director for the Brain Initiative. I'm going to introduce brain-funded hemodynamic imaging projects. First of all, a brief history of brain support of such technology development. The Brain Initiative made the first funding announcement for non-invasive brain functional imaging technology development in 2014 as a three-year preparation grant mechanism. We made the first full-scale development funding obtained announcement in 2016 and funded 12 projects in the space of hemodynamic imaging since then. Seven of them are magnetic resonant imaging, one on magnetic particle imaging, three on functional optical imaging, and one on photoacoustic computed tomography. Materials from the rest of my presentation come from these two resources. In February 2021, the Brain Initiative held a workshop on dissemination of non-invasive imaging technology. We invited all awardees to present their technology, and pre-recorded videos can be found at this website. You can also find the detail of all these projects from NIH Reporter website. In 2017, we funded three MRI system projects. So Dr. Gawood from University of Minnesota proposed to develop 1.5 Tesla head-only vertical bore MR scanner with a high-temperature superconductor magnet and a multi-coil array gradients for minimal mobility restriction. It's the first time for both technology to be applied to human brain imaging. Dr. David Feinberg from University of California, Berkeley proposed to develop very powerful, fast, resonant imaging gradients, which features around 800 to 900 Tesla per meter per second through rate and 128 channel receiver array to achieve 400 micron isotropic resolution for 7 Tesla functional imaging. Dr. Camille Wookbill from University of Minnesota proposed to further develop their 10.5 Tesla MR scanner with very fast gradient, featuring 900 Tesla per meter per second through rate and a 128 channel receiver array with a goal to achieve 0.1 microliter resolution, which is about 400 to 500 micron isotropic. In 2018, we funded other MR projects. Dr. Susie Huang from MGH proposed develop very strong MR gradients, which featured 500 millitesla per meter peak gradient strengths for 3 Tesla diffusion imaging. Dr. Thomas Fu from General Electric Research proposed develop a 7 Tesla head-only MR scanner that only requires 18 liters of liquid helium, which is less than 1% of that required by whole body system. And the system can provide a high through rate suitable for brain functional MR study. So as you can see from these multiple projects, currently the highest field strength we sponsored is at 10.5 Tesla. The highest gradient through rate is 900 Tesla per meter per second for functional imaging. The highest gradient strength for diffusion imaging is 500 millitesla per meter. And the maximum number of channel count for our receiver is 128. So that's the current state of the art. We also founded one project led by Dr. Doug Knoll from University of Michigan on the new MR sequence that can improve the signal noise ratio by 2 to 3-fold over current leading gradient echo method. Dr. Wei Chen from University of Minnesota proposed to apply dielectric material to boost the SNR of a radio frequency receiver. In this project led by Dr. Larry Wall from MGH, he's developing the very first human magnetic particle imaging system that can provide 10 times sensitivity improvements of cerebral blood volume measurement compared to functional MR, but with similar spatial resolution, which is about 2 to 3 millimeter. This is the very first in the world. We have three grants in the space of functional optical imaging. Dr. cover from Washington University at St. Louis led a project to develop a wireless lightweight, which is about 3 pounds, and the high-density FNIR array that can be applied to subject with maximum mobility. Dr. Maria Francini from Massachusetts, from MGH, is developing a high-density functional diffuse correlation spectroscopy array that provides better specificity for optical imaging study of brain function. Dr. David Boyas from Boston University is incorporating FNIRs, EEG, and eye tracking for neuroscience study in natural environments. Finally, we just funded Dr. Li Hong Wang from Caltech in 2020 to develop the 2048-element array that can cover the entire human cortex for photoacoustic computed tomography study. This device can provide 1 millimeter spatial resolution and 50 millisecond temporal resolution for hemodynamic study. So with this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you.